Students, today I am going to explain you about half cell, types of electrodes, electrode potential and cell potential, and few questions based on cell potentials. So first of all, we will try to understand what is a half cell. So again, if we draw Daniell cell in which we have zinc sulfate solution and zinc rod placed in it. Zinc sulfate is known as electrolyte and zinc rod is placed in it. Collectively, it is known as half cell and we denote it Zn, Zn 2 plus. Same way, if we consider copper sulfate solution in which copper rod is dipped, then this is also known as half cell. Half cell and half cell can make a complete cell. Remember, a half cell cannot produce electric current, but two half cells, by joining them, we can get electric current. It is also depicted as Cu2 plus Cu because this is cathodic reaction. This is depicted as Zn, Zn2 plus because it is anodic reaction. And the overall reaction is Zn will give Zn2 plus, plus 2 electron minus. Cu2 plus 2 electron minus will give Cu. That is solid. Here also solid. This is aqueous. Cu2 plus aqueous and Cu solid. So overall reaction is ZnS, Cu2 plus aqueous will give Zn2 plus aqueous plus Cu solid. Now we want to understand different types of electrodes. There are three types of electrodes. One is active metal electrode. Second is gas electrode and third is inert electrode. Generally, gas and inert electrodes resemble each other. Now, we will study what is electrode potential. The potential difference developed between rod and electrolyte, the potential difference that is developed between a rod and electrolyte is known as electrode potential. And from this we can understand about the cell potential. What is a cell potential? A cell potential is the electrode potential difference between cathode and anode. So if you want to find out E cell, then we generally write cathode value minus anode value. So by utilizing cathode value, reduction potential of cathode and reduction potential of anode, we can find out cell potential. So E cell is equal to cathode minus anode, C minus A in simple manner. Suppose in the Daniell case, if we know the potential difference Zn2 plus Zn, 0.76 minus 0.76 and Cu2 plus Cu to be 0.34. These values are having volt unit. So we can find out E cell is equal to cathode value minus anode value. So cathode value is 0.34 minus anode value is 0.76, that is minus. So 0.34 minus minus plus 0.76, it will give you 1.1 volt. So E cell value for Daniell cell is 1.1 volt. Now three different cases we want to understand for Daniell cell. Considering this value, suppose E external is smaller than 1.1 volt. E external is smaller than 1.1 volt, then the flow of electrons will be from zinc to copper. The flow of electrons will be from zinc to copper. So the current will be in the reverse direction, that is from copper to zinc. Same way, if E external is greater than 1.1, then it is opposite to the previous case, as I told you. And if we consider E external to be 1.1, then there is no flow of electrons. Remember, if E external is equal to 1.1 volt, then there is no flow of electrons. Now, when we are thinking of gaseous electrode, we have standard hydrogen electrode. Standard hydrogen electrode, whose potential is generally arbitrarily decided 0.0 volt. Potential difference or reduction potential of hydrogen electrode is decided 0.00 volt. By utilizing SHE standard hydrogen electrode to be 1/2 cell and joining other metals and non-metals, we can make electromotive force series. Electromotive force series. And if we know the values of reduction potential, we are able to understand some questions. Like, we have a question: can we store suppose we have a question that can we store CuSO4 solution in zinc vessel, yes or no? So to understand the answer, first of all, we have to know the reduction potential of Cu and Zn. Cu2 plus Cu 0.34 and Zn2 plus Zn is equal to minus 0.76 volt. So if we find out E cell, then E cell is equal to cathode minus anode value, that is 0.34 minus 0.76, comes out to be 1.1 volt. Since E cell value is positive, we can say that we are unable to store copper sulfate solution in zinc vessel. Thank you. Please like my channel.